Hi guys, Jimmy McIntyre here, and welcome to this video where I'll show you three different ways to blend exposures with Raya Pro 5. Raya Pro 5 was released last week and I sent an email out to all users to download that because of course all updates are free for life for existing users. If you're a user of Raya Pro 5 and didn't get the email, please look in the description of this video on YouTube and you'll see a link where you can log into your account and download the panel. Now here I've got two exposures, a brighter exposure on top, a darker exposure on the bottom. I want to blend the foreground of the brighter exposure into the foreground of the darker exposure because it's too dark. And as you can see, the sky in the brighter exposure is overexposed. So the sky in the darker exposure would be a really good replacement for that. Now I've got three groups here. One says QB, that's for quick blend. One's for IM, that's Instamask, and one's PM for precision masks. And in each of the groups, we've got exactly the same files. So you can see the difference between these types of blending techniques. Now, the very first thing I'll show you is quick blending because this is a brand new function called channel blending, which I integrated into Raya Pro 5. Unfortunately for CS6 users, you won't see any sliders. You'll just see buttons here because I couldn't add that function into CS6. So you won't have the same level of flexibility as CC users. Now, the great thing about this is I've got the bright exposure selected, so I go to the bright section, and I can bring along the slider bit by bit, and we start to blend those two exposures. And the more I bring it along, the more I bring in the sky. And the more I bring through the darker exposure. And the more I bring the other sliders along, again, the more I bring through the darker exposure. But I just want to affect the blue slider right now. And normally, when I start, I always start with the blue slider. I just slide it along, see if it works. If it doesn't, I move to the next slider. There's no rule for how to do this because every image is different. And that's all we really need to do to blend exposures using channel blending. Now, this is definitely the easiest way to blend exposures in Raya Pro and probably in Photoshop, to be honest. But that doesn't mean it's not an effective way to do it. In fact, you could blend a lot of different scenes using channel blending. And to demonstrate that, I recently released a course called Jimmy's Big 5 Photos, where I showcase my favorite photos. And in four of those photos, I use these exact sliders to come out with a really good final result. So this is a very powerful function for exposure blending. But next, let's move on to Instamask. So I'm going to make this group visible and select the brighter exposure from that group. And I'm going to open Instamask. And this is where we can create 16-bit luminosity masks. By the way, in quick blend, the channel blending, that is also 16-bit if you're working in 16-bit mode. So you're getting a really clean final result. So in luminosity masks, all I need to do to blend the exposures is to choose D1 because I'm trying to select the foreground here. And I can just bring the sliders along. And what I'm trying to do is trying to make the foreground white and the sky relatively dark. So that way we are preserving the foreground of the brighter exposure, but bringing through the clouds in the darker exposure. If I'm happy with that, I can choose the brighter exposure and just press apply. Now let's compare the two final results. So this is Instamask and that is quick blending. You see they do produce different results. But the reason why Instamask and luminosity masks are more powerful is because we have greater flexibility in how we use them. So we have this mask on our Instamask layer. I can, if I want, select a black brush with the mask selected and I can paint in the sky and look, I'm bringing through more of the sky from the darker exposure. But at the same time, I can switch my foreground to white and paint in the foreground and look, I'm bringing in the information from the foreground now. So look how much better that looks than the channel blending layer. Okay, the sky's probably a little bit dark here, but we could fix that easily enough. But it's certainly more dynamic and has more contrast than the channel blending layer. Now with channel blending, yes, we can create a mask on this brighter exposure, just as we did with the Instamask layer, and make that layer invisible. And we can also select a black mask and mask in that darker exposure just as before. But what we can't do is choose a white brush and mask in the foreground because the foreground is already visible. Look, it's white on the mask here. The reason why it's not reacting the same as the Instamask layer is because there's a certain blending algorithm applied to it. So luminosity masks give us more flexibility in blending these exposures. But nevertheless, channel blending is still a very powerful way to do things. Now, with PM precision masks, the good news is these are exactly the same luminosity masks as the ones in Instamask. So I can just press the brighter exposure, choose auto bright, make sure the brighter exposure is visible. And how they're different to Instamask is we can actually view the masks in real time. So with Instamask, we open a mask, we play with the sliders, and we press apply. But we don't know how that mask's going to look on the layer itself. And some people prefer to see how the mask looks as they work. So we've created all our precision masks and one's already on the layer. We can cycle through the various masks and see how they'd look on our layer. And we can decide which one's best. And we might think, well, this is pretty good, but I want to make some changes. We can press this edit button. And just as we could edit the mask in Instamask, we can do exactly the same here in precision masks. And if we're happy, we can press OK. Then we just press select. And now we've blended our exposures. And this looks pretty much exactly the same as the original blended result from Instamask. And just as we did with the Instamask layer, we can manually adjust that mask as we please. So we can bring through more of the darker exposure or more of the brighter exposure to create a more dynamic result. So Instamask and precision masks are near identical, but not exactly identical. The workflow behind them is different. And there are a couple of other ways to blend exposures, but most of the time, these three will do the job for you. And if you're uncomfortable with luminosity masks, you find them a little bit complex, I really recommend you use this channel blending function. But I should say that the same process is needed for preparing your raw files when exposure blending, regardless of the method that you use. So if you use luminosity masks or channel blending, you still have to prepare your raw files just as you normally would. So that's it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.